Vande Guru Padadandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Vande Nitta Ananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandanam Vande Radhika Charanodayam Gopijano Samayuktam Bindavanam Manohar Vanchakalpataru Vashakipasindhubhavacha Patitanam Pavane Bhavishnavibhyo Namo Namah Mukam Karoti Vachalam Pangung Langhaitagirim Yat Kipatamaham Vandi Paramananda Madhavam Vrindavitu Siddhapoi Piyavai Kesavasacha Krishna Bhakti Pade Devi Satva Bhattvai Namo Namah Narayana Namaskritta Naranchaiva Narottamam Devim Swaraswatim Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudire Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadeshe Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukto Bhakti Pramodaksha Yagod Varunya Deyam Sadapari Vavagnam Avishtaduham Tithas Padam Siva Virunchenutam Saranyam Bhitatiham Panatapal Bhavadiputam Bande Mahapurusate Charanaravindam Yat Pada Pallavanaka Chandamani Chataya Bispurjita Kimapikabhudu Swadarsh Purunahuragara Susagara Saramurti Saradhikamai Kadankibam Karosh Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Ajanulambita Bhujau Kanuka Badato Sankirtanai Kapitaru Kamalai Hutaksho Ishambaru Dijavaru Jugadharma Palo Bande Jagat Priyakaru Karuna Bhataru Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Namami Gange Tava Pada Pankajam Sura Surair Bandito Dibbarupam Bhuktin Chamuktin Chadada Sinitam Bhavanurupena Sada Naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano priyamanango madapaharam Varanasi purapati bhajavi shanatham Vagi sajusho padane Lakshmi Yasacha Bhakshasi Yasyasti De Sambit Pam Nishinga Maham Bhaji Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Dhana jivana jauvana rajya sukham nahi nito manukshana nasuparam tejo gramma kathasakalam vipalam bhada godruma kanano ranjividum bhaja godruma kanano ranjividum bhaja godruma kanano ranjividum. Gauriya Goshthipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru very often used to say that to see a sadhu, don't try to depend upon your eyes. You will have to depend upon your ear. You have to use your ear, hearing organ, to understand a proper sadhu. Because those who want to look a sadhu with this material darshan, they cannot understand. They cannot understand who is sadhu, who is not, because external glamour, position, rank, so much popularity can prove in front of that bonded soul that maybe he is very important personality, he is sadhu. Whereas Srila Gaurakishor Babaji Maharaj staying at the bank of Ganga and doing bhajan exclusively, nobody can understand he is sadhu at all. Bhangchidas Babaji Maharaj, Gaurakishor Babaji Maharaj, Bhagwan Das Babaji Maharaj, nobody understand. So usually Prabhupada used to give advice, used to speak, that always try to utilize your hearing organ, not your eyes. How? But if you can depend upon your hearing organ, then by his strong speech, transcendental sabda Brahma can give you impression. Surely, if there is no aparat, nothing, then surely you can understand something, because reaction, you can feel some reaction inside your heart. Some people can put argument, Maharaj, Prabhupada speaking that we will have to depend upon our hearing organ. So through hearing organ, if we can receive our Sabra Brahma or Prakita Sabda Brahma, then it is okay. But usually common people, they are in confusion because they don't know what is Sabda Brahma, what is material Sabda, what is material Sabda, what is transcendental Sabda. They have minimum difference, they want to understand. They don't understand. Actually, Prabhupada wanted to give advice that if somebody going to put argument that some so-called sadhu can have oratorship, then what? Some so-called sadhu can have oratorship. He can speak nicely, very nicely, and can give you enjoyment so nice you can start dancing. What will happen then? For them, it is our Siddhanta. For them, we are going to speak clearly that those who are putting this kind of argument, we are 100% sure they have no ABCD knowledge, no smell of spiritual, field. No, nothing. They have no experience. That's why they are going to put this kind of argument. Now, somebody can have oratorship. You can hear. Who many people? I know. Some Ramanandi Sadhu, some different Sampadaya, is going to speak Brahmar Gita. Gopi Gita in Vrindavan. Oh, thousands of people going there. I was then young, I thought everybody going that, Maharaj, everybody going to, what is happening there? What kind of circus? Let me see. I was 100% sure about Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Too many people going. I like to see for 5 minutes. I like to see what is happening, because he is known as international sadhu. I don't like to speak his name. Ramananda sadhu are international sadhu. Everybody speaking. But Mahaprabhu not speaking. Bhagavan not speaking. Prabhupada not speaking. Bhaktivinoda Thakur not speaking. People speaking. He international sadhu. I thought, okay, let me go there for 5 minutes or 10 minutes. Let me see. Then I was standing there so much, there is no place to sit. So I'm standing and hearing what is after that with black goggles, that sadhu coming in front of the stage, standing, and after that started doing bandana, started doing one gopi gita, one slok. After that, I was stunned to see what explanation he is doing. Are people so foolish? They are also running behind. Because they, Kesava Goswami are speaking, that we are at present, we are so foolish, what is not available where? Parambija Kesava Goswami are speaking, what is not available where? It is our, you know, it is our, you know, our mind is so fickle, we are running there. What is not at all available there? What he want, it is not at all available there, still we are running there to get it. Kesava Goswami is speaking, what is not available there at all, we are so foolish, we are expecting that kind of thing to get from that source. That is our foolishness. I come back, oh, I was so sorry. Where is the definition of Jiva Goswami path? Where is the definition of Vishwanath Chakravarti path? What Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Prabhupada speaking, oh my God. So people, thousands of people going there to waste their time. Another time, everybody speaking, he is a big speaker of Bhagavatam. Everybody gone there, everybody. So one day I thought, let me see, last time. So there actually I go and hear after Bhagavad Katha is over, he is going to offer the Bhagavad Katha unto the lotus feet of Katayani Devi. Oh my God! Then immediately I run from there. Oh, so foolish. Minimum Siddhanta Gyan is not there, but he is famous speaker. Famous speaker. Everybody going there, even Gaudiya devotee, because he is sometimes speaking Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's, you know, Sikha stock, everything. So idiot people, they are going there. He is actually against Gaudiya Math. Never unknowingly, he is not speaking, even not touching any philosophy of Gaudiya Math. Nothing. What to speak about Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada? Never. They have allergy. They have some allergy against Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, but they are going to hear. Okay. What feeling he don't have? How he can give this kind of feeling to you? How it is possible we are going to expect? He is going to offer the Bhagavad Katha fall unto a lotus feet of Katayani Devi. I was stunned. How it is possible? Bhagavad Katha, minimum Siddhanta is no, you know, minimum Siddhanta he don't know that Bhagavad Katha, Hari Katha and Hari, non-different. Hari Katha, Supreme Lord, and His Katha is non-different. That's why Gopi Gita, you know, Tapa Katham Ritam Tapta Jeevanam Kavi Viritam Kalama Sapaham. Isloka, you know. Now, actually, if somebody going to put argument, some oratorship can be there with somebody, can speak very nicely, then what? Because some general people can feel some enjoyment. Now, point is that, in that case, I am sure that he has no touch of, no smell of spiritual bhajan. That's why he is going to put this kind of argument. Because if you hear from a genuine source, it is my request, you can test it in your life. If you are going to hear from an original source mean, what do you mean by original source? What Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to say, what Prabhupada wanted to. Original source mean, that sadhu, he has direct realization, who has connection with this Vaikuntha Jagat, and directly the speech coming, and he is going to deliver to you. That is called Aprakita Sabda Brahma. If oratorship is there, that is not at all Sabda Brahma. And those who have common sense, they can easily understand. In between, they can make some Siddhanta Virodh. In between, they can memorize, so nice memory. But in between, they can make some Siddhanta Virodh, then you can understand is actually foolish. So, Prabhupada wanted to speak, wanted to give an advice, always try to depend upon your hearing organ to catch Sabda Brahma, if at all Harikatha there. Don't try to watch a sadhu with your material sight, material eyes. Don't try to see. Then you can get cheated. Very careful about that. Actually, it was the advice of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Actually, it is the advice of Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. Prabhupada always used to speak that in our daily bhajan procedure, we must keep a constant, we must try to keep a constant flow of Bhaktivinoda Dharma. In our daily bhajan life. Every time, every fraction of second, we must get in touch with Bhaktivinoda Dharma. Prabhupada going to advise us that please try to understand the different basic difference between Bhaktivinoda Dharma and non-Bhaktivinoda Dharma. Emotion is not devotion. Many times I told. Sometimes we become so emotionative, so we want to calculate on that basis. But emotion is not devotion. Practically, bhakti is the natural function of your soul. Bhakti is a natural function. When that Harikatha, Sabda Brahma going to touch your heart, automatically, yesterday I was speaking, na, Srinivasacharya, when explaining Rasa Lila chapter, Panchadhyay, then everybody there crying from heart, everybody, because it was touching their heart. And previous speaker, who was there in the Basasan previous day, is actually material speaker. He is going to get some pranami, position, rank, you know, nothing else, la puja patishtha, nothing. And also I was speaking about Jiva Goswami, but yesterday I was not satisfied by because I, within this short period of time, I couldn't speak all very, very vital points. So many points about Achintya Bhedavata, about that somebody going to complain that Jiva Goswami Pad not in the line of Rupa Goswami Pad and Sanatana Goswami Pad. How dare they speak like that, idiot? They are speaking that Jiva Goswami Pad surely not in the line, Anugatha of Sanatana Rup. I can explain under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Because any amount of Shastra in front of us there, actually it is written, the Ananta Param Kila Sabda Shastram, okay? And our brain is, you know, very weak, our heart is very weak. And so, to understand, we must depend upon Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You can remember Sara Goswami is talking there. Sara Goswami is talking, usually I speak to you can remember. Nana sastra vichara naiko nipuno, saddharma sanstapako, lokana mahitakari no tibubane, manyo sarana karu. You can remember. Nana sastra vichara naiko nipuno, Nibuno Saddharma Sangstapako. It is applicable for Saragoswami Pad. So those Saragoswamis, for them this sloka is applicable. Srinivasa is right. But we are 100% we can apply this sloka, this stotra, for seventh Goswami, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. 100%. Without any hesitation, we can use this Nana Sastra Vichara Naika Nipuno Saddharma Sangstapako. We can apply this sloka 100% without any hesitation for Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur, who is 7th Goswami. Sara Goswami all and after that those Goswamis, you know, different, you know, so many books they are compiling. But we have no ability, we have no power to understand, go into the deep of their philosophy. Especially, you know, it's so deep philosophy. Common people, what to speak about common? Even our Guru Varga speaking, if Bhaktivinoda Thakur not coming, our Guru Varga, I heard from Guru Varga, if Bhaktivinoda Thakur at all not coming in this material world, then who is going to understand? Who could understand the, you know, all the deep, you know, Siddhanta which are all those Goswamis? All those Sahajiyas, all those big, big, they want to prove that we are Pandit. They are explaining very wrongly, wrong way. We are very lucky that Gauranga Mahaprabhu sending his personal associate Bhaktivinoda Thakur in this material world, depute. So we have the facility to go through the writings of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and speech of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, which is the essence of all the volumes of works done by Goswamis. Volumes of total, you know. So powerful Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by his mercy, we are going to get the essence of all the writings of those Goswamis. We are very lucky. Otherwise, who could? Because especially at present, there is no such, you know, gigantic personality who can realize this point. Actually, what to speak more, from top to bottom, beginning to end, from top to bottom, all Gauriya Bhajan, Gauriya Bhajan especially, Gauriya Math Bhajan, Sri Gauriya Math Bhajan, top to bottom. Gauriya Math Bhajan means Rupanuga Bhajan. So top to bottom, starting to beginning, from morning when we get up, and at the end, all everything top to bottom, all Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Without Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we cannot understand anything. That's why Prabhupada was bound to speak. Then Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving us everything, all, total. It is our shortage of our, sincerity, that we cannot grasp, we cannot digest, even after getting this kind of help from Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So actually, total, from top to bottom, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada speaking, actually top to bottom, everything given by Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada speaking. We are getting everything from Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Only we will have to grow our sincerity and follow him properly. Then we can get everything, nothing else. Some common people, they misunderstand. So, you know, even no humanity. So I'm bound to speak. If the number of human being going to increase, then we are very expressing concern. Why, Maharaj? Because if there is no humanity, how we can say that human being come, taking birth? If the number of animal increasing in the forest, we are not going to express our concern. If the number of man increasing, so-called man increasing, we are going to express our concern. Because if there is no humanity, how we can say human being? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if there is no humanity, if there is no, you know, Tattva Siddhanta Vichar, nothing, no mercy, nothing, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to speak repeatedly, Jive Daya, Krishna Naam, Sarvadharma Sahab, Vaishnava, many times, many, Jaiva Dharma and Chaitanya Sikshamritam, Mahaprabhu, everywhere, in his Kirtan, everywhere, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, so many writing, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. Every fraction of second, Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to dedicate for the service of Sivan Mahaprabhu, Gauranga Mahaprabhu. That was his life. If I start speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur took birth near Krishnanagar, one place there, you know, and after that, if I go on speaking, what use actually? I can speak. But we are interested about this Bani Sarup. Ula Birnagar. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur took birth Ula Birnagar. And his schooling was done in Kishanagar, Gwari Bazar, there. And from childhood, he was so intelligent. Actually, you know, all Shastra, Gyan, Raman, Mahabharat, all everything, you know, everything was there in him. Knowledge, Vyakaran Adi, everything. So, what to speak about life, you know, about his life history. Actually, if we like to discuss about his Bani Sarup, it's more practical, I think. Everything is good. But if we discuss about his Bani Sarup, it's more, you know, effective, because common people, they are busy with history and they confuse. They don't understand that the Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the eternal parsad of Gauranga. Just a few days ago, I was watching one books written by some so-called Maharaj. I don't like to speak his name. He is writing that Bhaktivinoda Thakur was, you know, Mayavadi before. I was so angry, I like to beat him actually. What do you speak? Sometimes some Mahajan expressing this kind of leela. That's why if we are going to speak all about Bhaktivinoda Thakur, his life, you can misunderstand. You cannot understand. Like Srinivas Acharya, Srivas Acharya, when was sitting in Bhagavad Sabha assembly, and Devananda Pandit, you know, going to explain Bhagavatam, Srivas Acharya ji crying heavily. Then they throw Srivas Pandit, they take Srivas Pandit out of the assembly, throw outside. What a great offense. That's why common people, they don't understand. They are, you know, so foolish, they don't understand. That's why Prabhupada and our Guru Bhargava Kesava Goswami, they're all speaking. If we try to understand the Bani Sarup of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, it is more than enough. If somebody is going to put question in front of me, then Maharaj, have you seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur? So I cannot say that I have not seen. Also, I cannot say that I have seen. I cannot say that I have not seen. Because both wrong conception. Because if at all by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada and Guru Bhargava, if at all any impression, any feeling coming inside my heart about his Bani Sarup, maybe not complete. I am not going to speak that way. I am not going to express that kind of erosity that I have seen. No. But I have not seen, then means that when Prabhupada and all our Guru Varga, they are failure to represent the Bani Sarup in front of me. Whereas Bhakti Bhumat Puri Goswami, all they are speaking about Bhakti Mataropova all the time. Either they are failure or I am failure because of my bonded condition. In between, what can be? So that is why, if at all somebody is speaking that, have you seen Prabhupada, have you seen Kesava Goswami Maharaj, have you seen Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, we'll have to think twice before giving answer. If their Bani Sarup at all going to give you kripa fully, maybe that Bani Sarup giving you full impression about that Mahajan, which is more practical. His Siddhanta Vichari is everything. That's why ontological aspect and morphological aspect there, we are always busy with his Bani Sarup, not material thing. Material, the Bhaktivinoda Thakur life is not material. Is transcendental or prakita. But one or two points I can touch. He was born in a very, 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 very famous family. Very, very famous family. But by the time when Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur took birth, the condition of that, you know, hereditary factor was very poor. Poor in the sense, you know, financial condition, everything, all gone, everything. Very poor condition. Because otherwise they are from very high family. The Jiva Goswami Bhattra, very, very high family. Very, very high family. But to speak. But actually, where by the time when Bhaktivinoda Thakur took birth in Ula Birnaga, that time their condition of that family, it was very financial condition, everything very, very poor. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur was bound to, father was dead before. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was bound to take his mother and come to Calcutta to stay somewhere, to continue his education, everything. One point I can touch so that you can have a clear impression about this, that how the character and behavior of a Nitya Parshad. You can have information. Because those who are Nitya Parshad, eternal Parshad, their speech, their activities, their everything, totally exclusive. If you are not 100% material, then surely you can feel something. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur went there, and there he was somehow is continuing his education, everything, that's why. And after that, I am bound to speak that Srila Vidyasagar Mahasaya, after Panini actually writing Vyakaran. Panini Vyakaran is so big, Ashtadhyayi, but very big. It's called Sabdanu Shasanam, Anushasanam, regulation, total controlling over, you know, over language, you know, Vasa, Sanskrit Vasa. Panini got it from Shankar Bhagavan. Shankar Bhagavan, when he was doing bhajan of Sangha, I am giving indication actually, it is not, it has no link with, but still I am bound to speak. Panini was doing, doing austerity and penances of Shankar Bhagavan, calling tapasya. Shankar Bhagavan was bound to appear in front of him. After that, when Shankar Bhagavan going to disappear, he was playing his dumru. Dumru, you know, dum 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 in Shankar Bhagavan hand. So he played in such a way, technical way, that sound indicating, giving the formula of Vyakaran. Panini, by the mercy of Shankar, could realize, only playing the dumru, dum 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 dum, in a special way. That through this sound, Panini could realize the formula. After that, he went on expressing his, different Vashya writings. After that, Patanjali and other Rishi going to simplify it. They also wanted to make some commentary to simplify it, because it is quite impossible. Quite impossible to understand. After that, Vidyasagar Maharaj at present within the, I am speaking about within 200 years, within, at present time, 200 years. There was some evolution, actually. After Gauranga Mahaprabhu gone, there was some special period was there. After that, some 200 years or 250 years, there was a darkness, total darkness. If Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not going to send Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then nobody was there to explain. Nobody was there to explain that this is in the name of bhajan, this is cheating. Nobody going to explain that in the name of bhajan, this is teaching. It's all false. Nothing concrete. Only we are so lucky. But still we are unlucky because we cannot follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur properly. Under the guidance of those sadhu, those who are genuinely following Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. That's why you are not, so bad luck. So without Bhaktivinoda Thakur, there was no chance to understand. In the name of bhajan, so all rubbish going on. There was a darkness, there's a gapping. She's full of darkness. After that, some important personalities took birth. Maybe they are not all spiritual personality, but still, in material ground, I would say, very important in material ground. Like Vidyasagar Mahaja, Bangim Chandra Chattopadhyay, you know, so many, you know, some, they took birth after that. Actually, Vidyasagar Mahasaya was the first person who, on the basis of Panini Vyakaran, wanted to simplify it. Because people, they fear. In front of Vyakaran books, they fear. Tremendous fear. Oh, how to get entry? Oh my God. That's why Vidyasagar Maharaj, he wanted to simplify Vyakaran book. Is a Vidyasagar Vyakaran book, Vyakaran Komedi, through which he wanted to simplify all Vyakaran. Now my main point is that our Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he was student in the college, you know, Sanskrit college. He was, you know, is a student of Vidyasagar Mahasaya. Vidyasagar Mahasaya was principal of that college. He's a very knowledgeable personality. He is not having any idea about spiritual knowledge. So actually, Vidyasagar Mahasaya explaining Panini Vyakaran and everything. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, eternal prasad. So easily, all in the class, in the college, he was the topmost student. He was having so extraordinary superpower of brain. You know, after that, one day Vidyasagar Mahasaya going to explain in his class. Actually, I don't believe what I cannot see. What I cannot see, that I cannot believe. That is called totally materialistic idea. No, but externally you can find some mercy, everything, which is not at all mercy, because mercy of Vaishnava is actual mercy. But everybody is saying, Vidyasagar is not the ocean of Vidya. Vidyasagar also is the ocean of mercy. Material people speaking, I'm not speaking. Material people speaking. Because he was so merciful to help anybody, any financial well, any help. But still, I cannot say it is actually mercy. Because mercy, we can say, if a Vaishnava can help me to get back Krishna consciousness, if I can realize my eternal identity, that is called Jivedaya, mercy, actual mercy. Anyway, still I am bound to speak with material thing. That's why Vidyasagar Mahasaya was explaining, used to explain Panini Vyakaran. Vidyasagar Mahasaya, actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was a student of that class. One day Vidyasagar Mahasaya was speaking that Supreme Lord Bhagavan is impersonal. Supreme Lord Bhagavan is impersonal, no, nothing, we cannot understand. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the eternal Parsad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. He stand up in the class. Well, Pandit Masai, if you never mind, I like to put one question. What question? Actually, you write in his Bodhodaya. One book was compiled by Vidyasagar. One book, Bodhodaya. You write there in your book that what you cannot see, that you don't believe. You write in your book, yes. Then you have seen Supreme Lord. The Supreme Lord is impersonal. Have you seen? It is your practical experience. Then Vidyasagar was, you know, very he was speechless. Vidyasagar Maharaja was speechless. He couldn't answer the question. But anyway, Vidyasagar Mahasaya was not like Jadavacharya, who wanted to kill his student, Lakshman Deshik, Ramanujacharya. Vidyasagar Mahasaya was straightforward personality. Anyway, not spiritual, but still, okay. He could realize, my student is not ordinary student. From then onward, Vidyasagar Mahasaya started showing his compassion, love, for the student specially. Special help. Vidyasagar Mahasaya wanted to watch that student, who is not ordinary student. He used to love him. Not only that, one time, Bhaktivinoda was speaking, one time I was feeling one liver problem. inside stomach. There's big problem, liver problem. Amlashul, it is Bengali, I don't know in English what you are speaking. Amlashul. Then Vidyasagar Maharaj is so acute disease. Vidyasagar Maharaj came to know my this student is suffering. Then Vidyasagar Maharaj calling him, you come to me, I know the medicine. Then Vidyasagar Maharaj himself making medicine, Ayurvedic medicine, special medicine, and for 7-10 days he requests him, he advised him to take this medicine and you can get cure fully from the root. Really so? Not only that, Vidyasagar Mahasaya was so compassionate for Bhaktivinoda Thakur, the student, that when the financial position of Bhaktivinoda Thakur was not at all good, Kedarnath Datta, then Bhaktivinoda Thakur, after getting some degree, college degree, it was only Vidyasagar Mahasaya. He was ready to write one letter of, comment about this student, special student, to the authority there, there in, what is that place, is Bhubaneswar, Kotak. There, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, getting this letter from Vidyasagar Mahasaya, going there to get one service, called school service. Vidyasagar Maharaj was so powerful that time, even those, English people, that time it was English period, they also used to respect him. And later on period, we can find also those English, those who are, in charge, big, governor, they used to love Bhaktivinoda Thakur also very much. After that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur went on doing his, After that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur got service in Orissa, Puri. By that time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur already expressing his full devotional mood. And after that, actually there, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to take the charge of, deputy magistrate. And there, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was so powerful, he was so powerful to get control over the situation, which was almost out of control by government. Government couldn't, Bhaktivinoda Thakur could get control over Biskisan, one idiot, very yogi, very powerful yogi, but very wicked, very, very dirty yogi. Bhaktivinoda Thakur arrested him. For that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was suffering so much because by the cards of that, the yogi, not actually cards, he's speaking, I can destroy your family life. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, okay, by the mercy of Gauranga, if it is written in my luck, I can suffer. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur was suffering so much because out of his yogic power, he wanted to put Bhaktivinoda Thakur travel and all the, children there, boys and sons there. But still, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was fixed in his own position. Ultimately, he was arrested. He was put into jail. And there, that yogi, anyway. But main point is that there, Bhaktivinoda Thakur becomes so famous. Bhaktivinoda Thakur becomes so famous because his personality was so high and super personality. After that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to discuss bhakti, Bhakti Tattva in the special place inside Jagannath temple. One place is there where there is Jagannath, actually Mahaprabhu footprint, Padapit. Mahaprabhu Padapit is there. Just there Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to discuss Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, Bhakti Tattva, daily evening time. Still today, if you can go to Jagannath Mandir, you can discover still today some Uriya, Bhakta, all Bengali, so many devotees, they are coming and doing kirtan there. Harikatha not at present there still. But that time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to take, control over the, because he was the in charge of total activities of Jagannath temple. He was given responsibility. That time there was so much changes in the temple, so much, you know, regulation, everything. And Bhaktivinoda was speaking daily, when I am doing kirtan and harikatha there, I don't know who is coming every day. Somebody coming and giving me sweet dal. It is also favorable to my Guru Maharaj. It was also, and also I like it very much. Sweet dal. Bhaktivinoda was saying, I don't know, everybody. Why? Somebody coming to give me dal, sweet dal. Everybody, every day. It is the arrangement of Jagannath, you see. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing his own feeling in his, you know, in his books. After that, actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur came back here, and there were so many, you know, reason there. After that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur came back in Bangla also. Actually, Prabhupada took birth there, you know already. Again, after when Bhaktivinoda Thakur retired from his service, again Bhaktivinoda Thakur going there near Haridas Thakur Samadhi Mandir, in near Sargodwar, there Bhaktivinoda Thakur getting Satasan here, and there Bhaktivinoda Thakur going near Haridas Thakur Samadhi Mandir, they are going to do bhajan. Prabhupada Bimala Basada was also there that time anyway. So we are very lucky that Gauranga Mahaprabhu sent Bhaktivinoda Thakur to help us. Otherwise nobody can understand all those, you know, the gravity of Gauriya Bhajan, the secrecy of Gauriya Bhajan, the total. Because Prabhupada, you know, with you know, aprakita, you know, he's going to express it, you know, grief. Prabhupada speaking, everybody, you know, going to speak that Bhaktivinoda Thakur was more liberal, he was so strict. Bhaktivinoda Thakur that time used to allow Sahajiya, Kirtaniya, to Guru Kirtan, everything, and you are putting so much, you know, restriction. Then Prabhupada giving answer, you have not seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You have not seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur even. What to understand, what to speak about, you know, his, you know, Siddhanta Vichar. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur never wanted to give any permission to any Sahajiya. But we have seen some from Santibhu, some Kirtaniya coming, Ganesh Kirtan, they are doing. Oh, it was one kind of acting. It was one kind of acting. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to call them and he used to sit there. He is doing Harinam. Everybody can take darshan of Bhaktivinoda Thakur when they are going to here, coming here to Sahajiya Kirtan. Actually, through his Bani Sharup, you can find Prabhupada speaking. Through his Bani Sharup, you can 100% understand that in his whole life, Bhaktivinoda Thakur never making any compromise with the Sahajiyas, you know, nothing. No compromise with them. One time Bhaktivinoda Thakur was there in Kishanagar, and you know, this important personality, his name is Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay, Bankim Chatterjee. He was then in Kishanagar to take charge, portfolio changing. He is going to give this charge to him, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur going away from this place to some other place. That time, they staying together, but Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to explain him that Gita, this way if you try to explain is not good. If you, at all, if you can understand the procedure by Bhaktivinoda Thakur or the Vishwanath Thakur, this way, so popped up, so false ego. I am Pandit. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to give some idea, you know, but he is not ready to accept. Actually, we are really proud to speak this thing. That if at all Bhaktivinoda Thakur was interested to take the position of a material writer and poet, even Bankimchandra Chattopadhyay, even Rabindranath Tagore, it was impossible for them. If Bhaktivinoda Thakur at all, wanted to get position in a philosophical field, you know, dry philosophical field, as a writer, you know, then it was impossible for others. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur never wanted to take name, fame, position, material name, fame, position, nothing. So, if somebody is going to speak this way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was more liberal, Bhakti Prabhupada speaking, you have never seen the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. In his whole life, Bhaktivinoda Thakur never compromised with anybody. Never. He was not ready to make a compromise with anybody. He was so strict. Through his writing, you can get. So all the Goswami Gantha, you know, if you don't understand any Goswami Gantha, especially the Shatasandarbha, Rasamrita Sindhu, after that, you know, Hari Bhakti will all gist Bhaktivinoda is going to write so many books in front of us. Bhaktivinoda is going to write so many books in front of us, like Jaiva Dharma. If somebody is going to follow Jaiva Dharma, 100%, he can understand easily that then time condition, position, what was the condition that time. After that, gradually what is spiritual, what is actually bhajan, how to do bhajan, what is Gauranga bhajan, how to go up, and all this sahajya, comparative statement, everything, ultimately extract from Ujjal Nilmani, Hari Bhakti Vilas, all you can get in applied form. There in Jaiva Dharma, Chaitanya Shikshamrita, Mahaprabhu Shiksha, so many countless Kirtan Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, in his whole life, so many writings, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. If we at all can understand the Bani Sarup of Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur, is more practical, I think. Because material people always have material darshan. They cannot understand what is the gravity of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is such a great, you know, seventh Goswami, not a matter of joke. After sixth Goswami, he was the only man who could realize the total sandarbha, everything, all the writing, samna, and he was successful to present in front of us. Not only that, but also, I would say, Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he was the first person who started preaching Chaitanya Shiksha. He was the first personality. Who started explaining Chaitanya Shiksha, Mahaprabhu's teachings in different languages. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to speak in Bengali, Hindi, English, Urdu, Sanskrit, different language. He was the first man, first personality to represent Gauranga philosophy in front of foreign people in different languages. He was the first person. We are really indebted to Bhaktivinoda Thakur forever. We cannot pay Bhaktivinoda Thakur, impossible. We can never pay. That's why our Guru Varga writing actually, our Guru Varga going to show us the gravity of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Who is Bhaktivinoda Thakur? Gaur Parshad. You know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, about Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Guru Varga writing, Gurudam, Granthadam, Gauro, Dhamadam, Namadam, Muda, Bhaktidam, Bhuridam, Bande, Bhakti, Vinod, Kamsa, Sada. Gurudam, Granthadam, Bari Guru Varga writing, Gurudam, Granthadam, Gauro, Dhamadam, Namadam, Muda, Bhaktidam, Bhuridam, Bande, Bhakti, Vinodakam, Sada. Today is a special day, his appearance day. we are very happy to discuss. And if we can accept in our life all the teachings of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then we can surely get the keep of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, no doubt in it. So Gurudam Granthodam means Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by the request of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by the request of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Vimalapurusha, Saraswati coming here in this material world, about whom it is indication there in Padma Puran, about Prabhupada, already indication there in Padma Puran, Jhutkale Purushottamat, Utkale Jhutkale Purushottamat. Atat, in this Kalikal, Kalijuk, now this time, one Mahapurush, one gigantic person, big, Parshad of Bhagavan, can come in Purushottam Khetra, Jagannath Khetra, and from there, all pure bhakti cult, all pure bhakti, from here, really so. Prabhupada took birth there in Purushottam Khetra. Prabhupada got the full keep of Jagannath. After that, his name was Vimalapurusha Saraswati, because Bhaktivinoda Thakur could easily realize. Bhaktivinoda Thakur could easily realize and identify that this Vimala Prasad is not ordinary man. He is a Shakti of Bhagavan, Jagannath. That's why his name was there, Vimala Prasad Saraswati. That's why. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur easily realized. That's why his name, that's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he was ready to put his name in the name of Vimala Purusha, Vimala Devi, Chit Shakti. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur easily realized. So it is our mistake that we cannot realize. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur easily realized. Bhaktivinoda Thakur many times, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, passing this kind of remark, Vimala Purusha is not ordinary man. He is the eternal prasad of Gauranga. And at the same time, Prabhupada also could realize that Bhaktivinoda Thakur is not ordinary man. He is the Shakti of Krishna. The mutually they can understand, but common people, they are especially those who are going against antagonist, they are against Guru Vaishnava. They are always against Guru Vaishnava. How they can realize? So, about Bhaktivinoda Thakur, our Guru Bhargava teaching us that Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to give us books, Gaudiya philosophies, darshan, very purified way, so that common people can also understand Gurudam, and especially by the request of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada took birth there in Purushottam Khetra, Jagannath Khetra. So, by the request of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada coming. So, Gurudam, that's why by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur we get Prabhupada. What is the difference between Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada? Nothing, no difference. Actually, only the difference is that what Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak in his whole life, Prabhupada, in applied form, wanted to show us in his life. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur never told, we cannot find in the speech and writings of Prabhupada. Srila Siddhar Goswami Maharaj speaking, whole life, what speech Prabhupada speaking, what Harikatha Prabhupada speaking, what writing Prabhupada writing, Srila Siddhar Goswami Maharaj speaking, all by the desire of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. By the desire of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, always, each and every sentence to satisfy Bhaktivinoda Thakur. All the practical explanation or in applied form we can get in the whole life of Prabhupada. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, that all we can get in applied form in the life acharyaship of Srila Prabhupada. Even at the last moment when Bhaktivinoda Thakur was sick, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving order to him to go to Baligai. I cannot discuss this point because there is no relevancy here. So Prabhupada was bound to go there to find solution about Brahman Vaishnava by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This way, by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we are going to get Prabhupada. Without Prabhupada, we are blind. We are blind without Prabhupada, without Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we know nothing, all blind, you know. After that, it is written that Gurudam, Granthadam, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing so many granthas. Even some grantha, I don't know name. I don't know name. Because so many grantha Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote in his life. And also, I would like to say, by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, when Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj giving me order in his letter, you will have to do sampradayik seva in his letter. I was mad. How possible? I am penniless. I am staying in Vrindavan, Surya Kundo. No, nothing. But by the mercy of Guru Varga, I come back here in Bangla, Godrum Dham. And by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Guru Varga, Guru Maharaj, I was bound to publish Chhatoder Bhakti Vinod. That was my first publication. When I came back here, in Gurdwara, that was my first publication. I took this old book, which was published almost, 100 years back, almost 100 years back. So I went to Kalna, my Guru Maharaj's Sipat. I collected that book because it was the desire of Guru Maharaj. So I published that book. That was my first publication. After that, all the exclusive writings, very, very scientific writings of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, it is already ready, translated in English, already translated. We are going to publish with all, it is my request, you can go through all his writings to understand what is what. Otherwise, whole life you can, cannot understand what is actual bhajan. So, by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we are going to get Prabhupada. We are getting so many books, so many writings. Not only that, but also Dham Sarup. Because when Bhaktivinoda Thakur for official job went to Tarakeshwar, one place where Sadashiv is there, Tarakeshwar Mahadev is there. It is there in Hooghly, one place in Tarakeshwar. Then the night time, Shankarji Bhagavan came in his dream and speaking that Kedarnath, you have taken decision to go to Vrindavan to do bhajan, and here the secret Vrindavan, who can do this seva? Eh? You are going to take decision to go to Vrindavan? No, you have to do seva here. Then by the mercy of Shankar Bhagavan, by the order, Bhaktivinoda Thakur took decision well. But previously, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, I took decision that I can go to Radhakund there, and I Lalita Sakhi there, Kunja there, nearby, in that Kunja, Sananda Sukhuta Kunja it is called, that same place. There I can do bhajan and leave my body. But by the order of Shankar Bhagavan Vaishnavanam Yathasambhu, he was bound to change his decision, and he was very active by that time. He was busy, just like why we are speaking Bhaktivinoda Thakur 7th Goswami. Why we are going to speak Bhaktivinoda Thakur 7th? Why? Has some reason, na? Not only that, he is writing so many books, giving all the essence of the writings of Goswami paths, or Sar Goswamis, or all Goswamis. Not that. But also, he started expressing the jewel of Nadia. Nadia means Gauranga Mahaprabhu, his Leela spot, where, what Leela was, and there, that time. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur took a strong initiative to publish one, grab a map by the help of Hunter Sahib. Hunter, one foreigner, British, you know, British man. They originally find out all the geological position of Navadvip, Ganga. After the searching and searching, after that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he writing so many Navadvip, Dhammato, everything. And Chitra Navadvip, it was compiled. So, by Chitra Navadvip mean, what was the position of Navadvip, total Navadvip? Is Ganga, which position? Ganga was the Saraswati, which position? Oh, actually, what are changing, na? Geological, you know, position changing. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then time, what was the position? All Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we can come to know. Especially Navadvip, Parikrama Khanda, everything Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, you know, Bhaptaranga, Navadvip, Bhaptaranga, so many books, you can go mad. Whole life you read, you cannot, you know, complete. So vast writings, you know. Every fraction of second in the life of Bhaktivinoda Thakur was dedicated for the seva of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. So, not only, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was the first person who could realize, who started, you know, searching what was the actual birthplace of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. You know already, Nadia Prakash, you know, total, the history, secret, Leelas of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, which Leela, where, what happens, what happened, when. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur that time, after retirement came here in Sananda Sukhoda, and not, previously Bhaktivinoda Thakur came in Surabhikunjo. There Bhaktivinoda Thakur started doing bhajan. Usually Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you know, night time sitting for bhajan. When everybody is sleeping, then Bhaktivinoda Thakur doing bhajan whole night. Then from Saraswati, at the bank of Saraswati, there was Surabhi Kunj. Bhaktivinoda Thakur night time could see there is a transcendental light glowing there. Huge! So high power of light. Where from this? This is actually forest. You know, nothing there. In the morning time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur searching. Again night time doing, again watching. Day by day, Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to search the whole, you know, case and going to take information from those elderly person of Muslim, you know, people. They speaking, Babu, actually, we tried our best to grow crops and different sabji, everything here, but only tulsi growing. Bhaktivinoda Thakur took information from this Muslim old man, old persons, Muslim. They told, only we see, here nobody can grow anything. Nobody can grow. Anything cannot grow. Only tulsi. Then after that, by the mercy of Radharani and Krishna, by the mercy of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj coming from Surya Kunda. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj was there doing bhajan in Surya Kunda. After that, by the mercy of Gauranga, he took decision to come to Gaurdham in his last life. And after that, after coming here, he was doing bhajan here. Someday, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj crossing the river Ganga and going to the spot and dancing 125 years. But dancing, when Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj dancing out of ecstasy, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it was impossible. Like one young man cannot, even in Olympic, when those experts cannot, you know, athletics cannot jump. One jump, like one young, jumping high up. After that, it was indicated by Sri Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, Siddha Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, that this is the place, this is the exact place where Gauranga Mahaprabhu took birth. Not only that, but also when, by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, the foundation and the construction for the construction of Jogopit Mandir, there was, You know, the labor, they are digging mud. From inside mud, one adakshaja vigra was discovered. Prabhupada going to indicate this adakshaja vigra, Vishnu vigra. It was originally worshipped by Jagannath Mishra and Sachima. Really so, yes. Really so. After this foundation, when they are digging foundation, you know, they find those labor, they find was Vishnu Vigraha inside, from inside that mud. And Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada is going to speak that it is that Vigraha which was worshipped by Jagannath Mishra, Sachima, and Mahaprabhu used to offer Naivedya, Naivedya means offerings. Because Mahaprabhu never tried to take anything which is not prasadam. Always Sachimata offering, and Sachimata cooking, sometimes Vishnu Vidya also cooking, and Gauranga Mahaprabhu offering, and with tools, everything. After that, there anybody coming there. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur was a original, you know, the pioneer personalities. So pioneer personalities in Gauriya, Saraswat Gauriya society, Gauriya Mahan, the pioneer man. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur discovered Dham also, where what Leela, like Goswami Pass. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving instruction to Sanatana and Roop, you can go there and try to search what Leela, where happened, what Leela, Krishna Leela, same thing. Same thing. If you go through Navadvip Bhaktaranga, if you go through Navadvip Dham Parikrama Kanda, you can clearly see. It was only Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by his you know, transcendental vision, he could realize, he could see. And consulting our Shastra, what Leela happened where, you know, all Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. So, six Goswami is not a false philosophy. Six Goswami, he is a sixth Goswami, is not false philosophy. 100%. If you go through his writings, everything, if you go through his activities, life and precepts, if you go through his activities, what? For the total satisfaction of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. What not done by Bhaktivinoda Thakur? For the total satisfaction of Gauranga, what not done by Bhaktivinoda? What done by Bhaktivinoda? Not. What not done by Bhaktivinoda? Everything done by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So we are now in such a position, but still we are unlucky because day by day we are going to express our desire to avoid Bhaktivinoda Thakur and the, you know, his teachings, Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. We are really unlucky. Actually, we are really unlucky. But first of all, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, through his writing, everything, Saranagati, everything, first of all, Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to give us impression that life is unstable for 2 days. Try to get ready to get the spiritual treasure kept by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for us. But who is going to pay attention to his request? All is, you know, you can go through his writing, Saranagati, everything. Everybody like to jump into Raganuga Bhajan. They are less interested. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes so much kirtan, even more kirtan than Narottama Thakur. Narottama Thakur is more kirtan. Jamuna Baba Bali, last. Jamuna Baba Bali, at the bank of Jamuna, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, his own feeling, his writing, that time so many things. And Harinam Chintamani, Tattva Vivek, Jaiva Dharma, so secret book, Dasamul Tattva, what not written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. What not written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Everything clearly. If you go through Harinam Chintamani, you can get the total clear idea about Nam Bhajan, Nam Sarup. But we are idiot number one. We are less interested about this. Bhaktivinoda Thakur always writing so many kirtan, everything. And through kirtan, Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to give us indication about his Baba. What Baba is there? Kabe gauravane surodhani tate haradeha krishnavali. So many kirtan. কবে হবে বলো সেদিনও আমার ধন জন আর কবিতা সুন্দরী বলিব না চাহি দেহ সুখ করি জন্মে জন্মে প্রভু দেহ গৌর হরি অহেতু কি ভক্তি চরণে তোমার কবে হবে বলো সেদিনও ঠোর আছে উই ক্যান গো ম্যাড If we can carry only Kirtan book of Bhakti 100%, I can touch the lotus feet of Bhakti Muttakura and speak. If we can follow only Kirtan written by we can get Rupanuga Bhajan Siddhi. Clearly, some foolish people, they don't understand. They are less interested about the Baba Bhakti Muttakura. Bhakti Muttakura already expressing his Baba in different Kirtan. Sometimes speaking, at the last moment, Lalita Sakhir Ajagya Kinkari Binoda Dharije Pray. Bhakti Muttakur, with full humility, expressing Lalita Sakhir Ajagya Kinkari. Just, you know, useless lady servant of Lalita Sakhi Binoda Dharije Pray. Bhakti Muttakur giving identity, his name is Kamal Manjuri. Who could realize that Godrum Dham is Nandogram? Who has the power to realize that Nandogram is this Nandogram? Where is Govardhan? Where is Radha Kund? Who can realize without the help of Bhakti Muttakur? Who can realize you speak? Nobody. But still we are. Even Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj is so powerful sadhu. Sometime he used to come in front of Bhaktivinoda Thakur to get bhakti. You see, Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj also eternal person coming to get bhakti in front of Bhaktivinoda Thakur to hear Harikatha. So those who are from eternal person, eternal ground, they can realize their each other, they can realize their position. One day our Bhagavati Ma, the mother of Prabhupada, coming to Navadvip Dham to take darshan of the lotus feet of Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj. Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj was there in Kulia, Navadvip, that side of the river. Bhagavati Ma coming with something in hand, you know, fruits, and going to take darshan and pay dandavat unto the lotus feet of Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj. Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj asking, Ma, mother, what for you are coming to Navadvip? To for marketing? You are coming here in Navadvip for marketing, special marketings? Because in Navadvip specially, and those were, you know, bell metal, all things, ganta, kasa, all special things. So Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj asking, Ma, my mother, what for you are coming in Navadvip, some special ground for marketing here? Eh? No, I am coming here to take... You are coming to me? You are coming to me? You don't know? The eternal Gaur Parsad is there in your house. Eh? You don't know? You have no information? Gaur Parsad there inside your house. You are coming here long distance to pay dandavat to me. Oh my God. Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj. Not only that, but also Bhaktivinoda Thakur sometime used to give ashirvad, blessing to Gaur Kishor Baba. If I go on explaining this inner meaning, it will take long time. What is the secrecy? Are Maharaj, some common people speaking that Gaur Kishor Babaji is a total detachment. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur doing bhajan also, but not through detachment. Through boga. Popa speaking, fool is idiot number one. We can discover all the same. What kind of Vairagya there in Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj? Same Vairagya and no different in quality. Only externally manifestation is different. Manifestation only different. Nothing else. All same. Because Prabhupada speaking, in the life Jivan Leela of my Guru Pad Padma, Srila Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj, I have seen the total reflection of the exclusive Vairagya shown by Raghunath Das Goswami. Same thing I have seen in the life of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Maybe expression is little different. Bhaktivinoda Thakur sometimes used to bless Gaurakishore Baba. Tomar bhairagya siddhi ho. You know Bengali? Learning Bengali, foolish. Tomar bhairagya siddhi ho. Your bhairagya can come out successful. What do you mean? What do you mean? Eh? What Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak? Eh? Was there any shortage in Bhairagya in Gaurakishore Baba? No, Maharaj, no, you cannot understand. Those who are, you know, Guru Varga, they can realize. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving blessing to Gaurakishore Baba. Tomar Bhairagya Siddhi ho. Your Bhairagya can come out successful, can express his external beauty, so that people not going to take care of dry Vairagya. They can realize that Yukta Vairagya is there inside. What is Yukta Vairagya for Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj? It is dry Vairagya for him. Because inside Gaurakishore Baba, it is quite natural. He is going to take dry rice means raw rice without cooking. Washing with Ganga water, offering with Tulsi to Gauranga. But if you want to do this kind of Vairagya, you can fall down. People understand dry Vairagya or people understand enjoyment. In between there is a sophisticated way. There is one. That is called Yukta Vairagya. Nobody knows. Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to express this point so that people cannot misunderstand Gaurakishore Baba. They cannot understand. It is impossible. That's why Bhaktivinoda is speaking that so that common people can understand the sophisticacy, so that common people can, so that those who are actually common people having no aparad, they are at all, if they are interested to do bhajan, they can understand the sophisticacy of your vairagya. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur blessing, tomar vairagya siddhi ho. Siddhi ho mana? Already siddhi is vairagya. But siddhi mana? So that common people can understand is Yukta Vairagya, all what you are doing, all for the total satisfaction of Gauranga, it is not dry Vairagya, Yukta Vairagya in the line. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur actually writing so many books, it is my request. Actually, Lalita Prasad Ji Maharaj, actually, externally we can find he is the younger brother of Prabhupada, previous home, ashram. They have their group actually in Vrindavan also, one doctor is there, here also, you know. Some of them, they wanted to give the diary of Bhaktivinoda Thakur to me. But I already heard from Guru Maharaj that common people, if they like to take information about Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they cannot understand. They can fall down. Bhaktivinoda Thakur like child, like a small child, writing everything. Externally you can find all material. So it is my request. It is my request in front of you all. Try to concentrate on the Bani Sarup of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Don't try to take information. You can misunderstand. Same thing. When somebody taking permission from Prabhupada, can we go to take darshan of Bhaktivinoda Babaji Maharaj or, you know, Gaurakishore Baba? Baba said, no, 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 don't go, don't go. You cannot understand their mood. You cannot understand their lila. So you can misunderstand. Eh? You can misunderstand. Bhaktivinoda Babaji Maharaj, with a false, you know, tobacco, there is no tobacco, but the instrument is there, with pipe. Previous days, all those kings and, you know, Jamindar, they used to take this kind of tobacco is there originally, that plus, and through pipe, they are actually taking enjoyment. And there is water filtration. Sometimes Bhaktivinoda Babaji Maharaj used to show to in front of Gaur Nithai, this false instrument, and then try to take that. This is no tobacco, false, actually. False. Is somebody going to meet Vamsidas Balaji Maharaj? They can understand. They can misunderstand and fall down. But when Vinodda, our Keshav Goswami went there, most no misunderstanding. Vamsidas Balaji Maharaj could realize he is also not ordinary man. So it is their internal adjustment. We externally, if we like to play our, you know, brain, logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of the absolute truth. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I already told that Prabhupada always could see. Prabhupada always can see. Prabhupada is Nitya. Prabhupada can always see the beauty of the lotus feet of Radharani inside Bhaktivinoda Thakur. That is his ideal, exact identity. Exact identity. Don't try to take any other information. Foolish people. They do diary. You know. That diary was stolen. By chance Guru Maharaj's diary also went to America. We cannot get. So somehow by the mercy of Guru Maharaj, I was able to write something. It's by his mercy. Very small. If some time permit, I can publish in English. It was published in the 100-year centenary of Guru Maharaj's Abhirbhav Tithi, 100 years completion. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur took Diksha from Jannava Thakurani line, Nityananda Sakti. Also, you have the 100% possibility to misunderstand Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So it is my request. Don't try to understand that way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the eternal person. Bhaktivinoda Thakur took Diksha from some place. You know, bolo. And there, before Kalna, one Bhagnapada, Gosai there. But later on, Bhaktivinoda Thakur started writing in such a way, then everybody can realize their Siddhanta has a major difference with Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I don't like to speak anything more about that. It's very sensitive issue. Don't know question of, you know. I am less interested to criticize anybody. But I am very much interested to establish the Siddhanta of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I am very much interested. If somebody misunderstands me, Maharaj criticizing, no. But it is the order of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Don't try to make any compromise with those negative world, Sahajiya. They have their understanding, Maharaj, you should not speak anything about my shortcomings. And I also not going to touch your senses. This is understanding. But I am going to follow the instruction given by Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. I am not going to follow your instruction. You can criticize me. You can say Maharaj going to criticize. You can see. It is up to you. But at all if I am going to criticize, next day my Harikatha can stop. You are foolish. You don't know Siddhanta. The day I am going to criticize somebody, some genuine Vaishnava, next day I cannot speak Harikatha. I can stop. This is original Siddhanta. You should realize this point. Anyway, Bhaktivinoda Thakur got Diksha from there, but it is not an eternal person. What kind of Diksha? Prabhupada was initiated by Gokisabha. And what kind of Diksha? Eternal person there. Anyway, I don't like to touch this point so much. But anyway, Bhaktivinoda Thakur got this Bhakti Vinod Thakur. This title, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, got from Bhagnapada Gosai. They confer, they in written, you know, paper, they have given this, you know, indication that Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur, this title was given by them, Bhagnapada Gosai. Anyway, but there was a major difference between their Siddhanta and Bhaktivinoda Thakur Siddhanta. I don't like to touch this point, but anyway. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur ultimately going to identify himself in a very humble way. Very humble way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to identify himself. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I wanted to explain yesterday, but time, I couldn't get time. But today I like to prove that even if something written by Rupa Goswami Pad, something written by Sanatana Goswami, something written by, you know, Jiva Goswami Pad, But if we can take shelter unto a lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then we can get exact realization. Exact realization. Otherwise, we can grow our fighting. We can grow our fight. If somebody putting question in front of me, Maharaj, when actually that our Madhavendu Puripat took birth, that time Gauranga Abhirbhava was not there. So how we can understand, how we can say Bhaktivinoda Thakur told and Prabhupada told, he is the main, you know, pillar of Gauriya Stambha. We are not going to accept it. Okay. As you like, it's up to you. If you, but Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada already explained that though we can find that Gauranga Mahaprabhu's appearance was little bit after, but be sure, when Gauranga Mahaprabhu took birth after, appearance was much later. But at the time of, you know, that Madhavendu Puripad, this kind of bhakti impossible. This kind of bhakti quite impossible. Until and unless if somebody going to get the keeper of Gauranga, the molten gold, Sarno Avatar. So Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda speaking, maybe Gauranga Mahaprabhu come late, but still, the Gaur Avatar, the molten gold complexion of Gauranga, was already manifested inside the heart of Madhavendu Puripad. That is why that kind of ecstatic love already expressed. Even Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking that actually, you know, South Indian, that, you know, Billamangal Thakur, ultimately he also got the keeper of Gauranga, who lived 750 years, almost 800, at the bank of Brahmakunda, always absorbingly in Leela. Maharaj, how is possible for a man to live so long? Yes, Toilanga Sami, one actually Shankar, he used to worship Shankar, bhajan of Shankar Bhagavan. 350 years, Toilanga Sami, one Marathian, you know, sadhu. Sadhu, actually this word is only applicable for Vaishnava, but casually I am speaking. Sadhu means, who is going to follow Sadharma. Sadharma means Jayavadharma. Sadharma means Bhagavad Dharma. Sadharma means, you know, Vaishnava Dharma. I already told, na, yesterday, that Srimad Bhagavadji Mahapurana is the total explanation of Vedanta. Total. From Guru Purana we know, Artho Ayam Brahma Sutranam. It is a complete explanation. Srimad Bhagavadji Mahapurana is a complete explanation of Vedanta Sutra. Artho Ayam Brahma Sutranam Bharatartha Vinirnayaha. Artho Ayam Brahma Sutranam Vāratārtho vinirnayaha. What is written in Mahabharata, you can get exact explanation. If you try to read Mahabharata directly, you can fall down. You cannot understand. You can misunderstand. So, artho ayam brahma sutranam Vāratārtho vinirnayaha gayatri vāśya rūpa asau vedārtho paribhingitaha. About Srimad Bhagavati Mahapurana it is written, it is total explanation Gayatri Vashya. When we are going to start Bhagavatam, Janma, Dasu, Yato, Anamaya, Ditarashvat, Savigyasara, you know, total, first look, Asana Bhagavatam. After that last, we are saying, you know, Satyam Param Dhimahi, Satyam Param Dhimahi, the last line. Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, the Gayatri, Srimad Bhagavadji Mahapuran, total first line, first sloka of Srimad Bhagavadji Mahapuran, 18,000 sloka, the first sloka itself, going to explain, you know, first sloka going to indicate the secrecy of Srimad Bhagavadji Mahapuran, everything there, what not. Everything there we can find in, you know, that first sloka. And Prabhupada saying, Bhaktivinoda Goswami is actually Gayatri. Gayatri, very secret, Gayatri actually. Satyam param dhimahi. Dhimahi? So, Prabhupada speaking, Vyasadeva Goswami is not selfish. Vyasadeva Goswami is so merciful. So, he is writing, Satyam param dhimahi. If at all Vyasadeva Goswami like to concentrate on his own bhajan, he would have written this way, Satyam Param Dhimahi. But he is writing plural, Bahuvachan. Dhaim Satyam Param Dhimahi. Dhaim Dhimahi. Dhimahi Satyam Param Dhimahi. All you can come and join me. We all together, without any self-interest, we can discharge, we can do the service of that absolute truth. Satyam Param Dhimahi. If Bhaktivinoda Thakur is not there, who can understand? Bhaktivinoda is saying, all the secrecy of Brahma Sangeeta, I like to speak so much, but time cannot permit. I like to give you indication that Bhaktivinoda Thakur ultimately wanted to identify why Bhaktivinoda Thakur waiting with full patience to get the complete kippa of Gauranga. Already you enjoying complete kippa, but still is in a humble attitude. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Suro Sarid Upakante Godrume Gauratirthe Vasati Suro Vikunje Bhakti Purvam Vinodaha Yugala Charana Seva Shaksho Labha Saya Asau Brujo Raso Rasikaya Pada Padamasrai Atro. Atro mane here. Jatro Tatro Atro. Atro mane here. Bhaktivinoda giving identity. That Suro Sarid Upakante. Suro Sarid Upakante Godrume Gauratirte. What is the meaning? Suro Sarid. Sarid mane? Nodi, river. Suro Nodi mean Ganga. So Bhaktivinoda writing is Suro Sarid Upakante. I mean, at the bank of Ganga, Godrume, at Godrumdam, Gauratirtho, where the playground of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, sitting in Surabhikunja. Basati Surabhikunje, Bhakti Purvam Vinadaha. Try to do utmost, you know, trying his best to express bhakti, full, you know, resolution. Basati Surabhikunje. To do seva. Seva means bhakti. Basati Surabhikunje. Sitting inside Surabhikunja, Bhakti Purvam Vinadaha. This Vinod, I mean, Bhaktivinoda was speaking about himself. Why you are sitting? Well, Jugala Charana Seva, Shaksho Lava Saya Asau. Jugala Charana Shaksho Seva? What do you mean? Jugala Charana Seva, Shaksho Lava Saya Asau. Asau meaning? Why Bhaktivinoda was speaking himself? Why I am sitting here? To get the excellent Seva of that Jugal, Radha Govinda Seva, through Gauranga. Through Gauranga. Jugalo Charana Seva, Shoksho Lava Asaya. Lava Asaya. Asamane hope. With great hope. With great hope to get the excellent Seva. And Nitya Jagat. Brajo Raso Rasikaya. How? What is the technique? How I am sitting? Mana Brajo Raso Rasikaya. Pada Badamasrai Atro. I am taking shelter unto a lotus feet of those Bhajara Sikh. Those are Rupanuga devotee. Brajo Raso Rasikaya Pada Padamasrai Atro. Atro mani here. I am sitting. But be sure I am taking full shelter of those Raganuga devotees. Hi, if I can get Gaur Kipa. When I can get? He already getting Gaur Kipa. Still saying, when I can get Nitya Seva, when I can get this kind of crying and crying all day and night, this way Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to express his identity, what is bhajan procedure, how and why he is sitting at the bank of Surabhi. So you try to remember this sloka. Suro sarid upakante gadrume gauro tirthe basati surabhi kunje bhakti purvam vinodaha jugalo charana seva shokshu labha saya asau brajo raso rasi kaya pad padmasrayatro. With humble attitude I am sitting in at the bank of Ganga. When I can fulfill my heart with full hope, I am sitting. I don't know I can come out successful with my hope. This is the mood of Bhaktivinoda, humble mood. But anyway, Bhaktivinoda always wanted to indicate, without the complete shelter of Harinam Prabhu, all Raganuga, Ruganuga, Bhajan, all one kind of drama. Naam bina kichu nahi ko aro chodo bhuvano maje. After, before that, like writing, na? Jivaro, jivaro kalyano sadhano kram. Jagate asiye madhura naam. Aha. Oh, nice. But you are going for, you are going for morning walk. You are not doing this kirtan. I can break your leg. You are not doing it. Through this, you can have a nice chance to do dham parikram. You are not doing kirtan properly. From morning to night, those who are not doing kirtan from morning to night, non-stop, he is not at all Raganuga Bhakta. They can never get chance. Handa Prabhupada giving this indication. From morning to night, from morning to night, all day and night, always they are interested to do kirtan, harikatha, kirtan, harikatha. They are actually Raganuga. What is the symptom of a Raganuga devotee? Without any expectation, La Puja Patishta, they are going to give the whole blood for you all. For, oh my God, foolish people, they don't know how Guru Vaishnav giving us energy, oh, to change our life, giving us, you know, full love, blessing us all the time, but we cannot realize this point. So foolish we are. Now I am going to give some touch so that you can understand very clearly. Bhaktivinoda Thakur helping us big way all the time. Brahma Sangita Tika written by Jiva Goswami. Okay, but who is going to understand? So secret thing. Also in Sanskrit, common people don't, and they are not Pandit, they cannot understand. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur taking trouble to give explanation in such a way. Brahma Sangita. We are really ever grateful. Gauranga Mahaprabhu ever grateful to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Ever grateful. Aha. So nice explanation. Those who are going to misunderstand Jiva Goswami Pad, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. Oh, oh common man, never try to misunderstand Jiva Goswami Pad. He is our Gauriya Tattacharya. Maharaj, you are also Tattacharya. I can say to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you are also Tattacharya. You are also Tattacharya, like Jiva Goswami Pad. But anyway, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Jiva Goswami Pad is our Tattacharya. Also, he has the eternal seva in Nityadham, Vilas Manjari. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is eternal in Kamal Manjari, but not speaking now. He cannot have any misconception about Nitya Leela, because they are watching that Leela in Golok Dham and writing. They are watching when, now it is my question to you, how it was possible for Jiva Goswami Pad to compile Shato Sandarbho Sarva Sambadini? Now if I put question in front of you, how it was possible for Jiva Goswami Pad to compile all Shato Sandarbha there, whereas no library there, nothing there, no help. Only water program. How it is possible Sunatha Rup to write, you know? Oh my God. The eternal parshad of Gauranga. Gauranga Mahaprabhu also giving indication. Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami praying to Gauranga, Sanatana Goswami speaking, Prabhu, we are bonded soul. Sanatana Goswami speaking, we are bonded soul. How we can compile all accurate Shastra Siddhanta? It is not possible. If at all you are going to put your lotus feet on my head and give blessing, then at all it can be possible. Rupa Goswami has a humble attitude, that's why before writing, Rasamrita Sindhu writing, you know, I am useless. Rasamrita Sindhu, Rupa Goswami, I can discuss this point tomorrow. Today, no time, actually. Oh, Maharaj. Pabhitto aham barak rupo pi, this sloka. Very nice. I am useless. I am foolish. But still, by the mercy of Gauranga, I am going to take care. I am taking, you know, going to take, you know, power to write this Rasamrita Sindhu. So humble they are. Sanatana Goswami, Prabhu, it is not possible. If you can put your lotus feet on my head, then it can be possible. Then Mahaprabhu going to put his lotus feet on the head of Sanatana. Whenever you write to like, whenever, Mahaprabhu giving blessing, whenever you like to write anything, any topics, then by the mercy of Krishna, you can see everything inside your heart. Follow what I mean to say. Why I give this argument? How it is possible for Jiva Goswami Pad to go there in a village area? Village. Remote village. Vrindavan Dham. You know, in Baigaon. No facility. Jiva Goswami Pad writing all Sandarbha. It is the blessing of Gauranga. Whatever you like to write, by the mercy of Krishna, you can see everything inside your heart appear. All Tattva Siddhanta, everything you can write. Similarly, when Prabhupada want to do something, Bhaktivinoda want to do something, they can see clearly inside their heart by the mercy of Prabhupada, by the mercy of Gauranga. They can see everything. That's why their writing is exclusive. Show power in their writing and speech. And those sadhus, if they are not in line with Rupanuga Dara, Bhaktivinoda Dara, how it is possible for them to speak and write about different tattva vigyan? How it is possible? You will have to calculate and find out. Now I like to touch one or two points. That Shankaracharya writing so many, you know, from Upanishad, going to select some word from Upanishad sloka which is favorable for what is favorable for him to establish Mayavada Siddhanta. But be careful, Shankaracharya not going to touch even one word of Srimad Bhagavatam. Shankaracharya not going to touch even one word of Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam, because Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Ji Mahapuran is no other than Krishna himself. Jiva Goswami, you know, Sukhdev Goswami is speaking, Krishna Parivartito. Krishna coming in this form, sound incarnation. So, Shankaracharya always wanted to avoid this Bhagavatam, but when he was very much interested to collect some special word from Upanishad, Vedanta, here, there, and to establish his Mayavada Siddhanta. Out of that, I am going to speak one or two. Tat-tam-asi. I can explain in details after some time. Not now, no time after Kartik. Tat-tam-asi. You are that Brahma. Really, qualitatively also, by Shankaracharya wanted to say, you are Brahma yourself. Tat-tam-asi. But Gaudiya Siddhanta, Tasho-tam-asi. You are His. And you are Jivatma, they are Krishna's. Tasho-tam-asi. not tattvamasi, you are not Brahma, but your colored quality will be awesome. Aham Brahmasi, I am Brahma. You know, neho nanyasti kinchana. This kind of different selected sloka, Shankaracharya going to select from Upanishad to establish his Mayavad Vedanta Vashya, it is not applicable for us. We cannot use it. Anyway, I am going to give you some documents that those are material people, they are going to put some argument that Jiva Goswami Pad at all not going to, you know, follow Sanatana rule. Because Jiva Goswami Pad is going to establish, you know, Sakya Bhav, and Sanatana Rup always in favor of Parakya. I already discussed 2 years back at the time of Gopurnim. Still I like to touch to prove that without the help of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we are blind. There can be so many writings about, you know, Goswamis, those Goswamis, but we cannot understand properly without the help of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. Now, Bhaktivinoda Thakur in his Ananda Chinmaya Raso Pratibhavita Vi Stavirja Evo Nijodupo Tayakala Vi Goloka Evo Nivasati Akhilatma Bhuko Akhilatma Bhuto Govindamadi Purusham. Someday I can explain this sloka. Ananda Chinmaya Raso Pratibhavita Vi Stavirja Evo Nijodupo Tayakala Vi. This sloka Bhaktivinoda will explain so nicely explained. There is no scope that we can misunderstand Jiva Goswami Pad. Bhaktivinoda wanted to prove that Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to protect those foolish people. Jiva Goswami Pad always wanted to protect those foolish people. They cannot understand. They cannot understand, they can misunderstand. That's why they can misunderstand those Gopikas, Radharanis. That's why Jiva Goswami wanted to put this kind of argument so that common people cannot misunderstand. But still they understand. That's why Bhaktivinoda writing in so scientific way that even those who are idiots still going to fight, they are bound to change their Siddhanta Vichar. It's not good to criticize Guru Bhargava, whereas we have no access. We cannot understand. Who can understand Jiva Goswami about their mood? Bhaktivinoda is speaking. And not in details, I am going to touch this point because no time. Bhaktivinoda speaking, actually Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to save all foolish people, those who are always busy with argument. Actually Jiva Goswami Pad 100%, 100%, not 100%, 100% Rupanugo, topmost Rupanugo, whereas we are Guru Bhargava writing the Pranam Mantra of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Namo Bhakti Vinodaya. Writing, Namo Bhakti Vinodaya, Sachidananda Namini, Gauru Shakti Sarupayo, Rupanugo Varayate. Rupanugo Varayate means, Rupanugo all devotee can be there, out of them he is a special, topmost. Same thing Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to point out that Jiva Goswami Pad is the topmost Rupanugo Acharya. Topmost Rupanugo Acharya. Not only Rupanugo, 100%. But foolish people, they cannot understand. Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur was bound to write this way, to establish the Sakya, only within a short compass, I like to explain. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, anyway, people speaking, Shakya Bhav, Parokya Bhav is there in this, in Bhauma Vrindavan, in this Vrindavan, here we can find, you know, Bhauma Vrindavan. Here we can find Parokya Bhav, always. But why Jiva Goswami wanted to establish Shakya? Bhaktivinoda giving evidence, actually, Parokya Bhav, what Bhav is there in Brajadham? What Bhav is there in Brajadham? Same Bhav originally there in Golokdham, eternal. This Vrindavan and that Golokdham non-different. Only the difference is there, you know, where Sarup Siddhi Vasu Siddhi, there are two terms, Sarva Siddhi, after Sattva Siddhi. Still, if somebody is going to look, they can find some contamination. Because it's the arrangement of Maya. Some. And you can mixing. Mixing. Because it's the arrangement of Yogamaya, they are. So here we can find Radharani is the wife of Ayan Ghosh. I can explain someday. Because this Radhashtami, I was busy with some other, you know, Siddhanta Vichar. Next Radhashtami, I can explain what Bhaktimitta wanted to speak, Prabhupada wanted to speak, and all eternal Siddhanta Vichar, and how secret way Radharani want to serve Krishna. All I like to establish next Harikatha, when Radharani appearance, disappearance, I speak in different way. From different angle, we have to understand, you know, realize this, you know. So, you see, Bhaktivinoda was speaking, what Baba available in here in this, you know, Bhauma Vrindavan, surely that Baba is there, eternally present in Nityadhama. But Jiva Goswami wanted to establish Sakya Bab, because in Golok Vrindavan, there is no Ayan Ghosh, there is no Jotila Kutila, there is no Kangsa, nothing. Only Baba is there. I have my husband there. What if he is going to know what will happen? This kind of Baba, fear, is going to give full nourishment to this Parakya Bab. So Jiva Goswami Pada anyway going to explain, anyhow, Ananda Chinmaya Raso Pratibhavitavi Stavirja Eva Nijarupottaya Kalavi. According to this explanation, explanation of this slok, actually Krishna and those Gopika, they are Sarva Shakti, non-different. There cannot be any husband, not at all possible. That's why Jiva Goswami Pada originally wanted to prove that they are not Parakya Sakya, to save us, foolish people. But Jiva Goswami never wanted to speak, there is Parakya Bab is not there, original. Bhaktivinoda Goswami, no, you misunderstand. Actually, Parakya Bab is in here, Bhauma Vrindavan. Originally, it is there. Originally, surely, 100%. And this Bab, without this Bab, because in Chaitanya Chaitanya we can find Parakya Bhavi Hoy Rasir Ullas. If Parakya Bab is not there, excellent rasa, you know, overflowing rasa, we cannot get. I can explain it. Don't take it otherwise. Yesterday I wanted to speak so many things about Jiva Goswami, but I'm very sorry I couldn't speak. I couldn't speak. I want to speak so many things about Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada, but time cannot permit. Excuse me, I like to beg pardon from you all. Today I will have to stop. So, first of all, you should realize what Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. What is? Dhano jivana jauvana rajya sukham nahini tamanu kshanara naso param tejo gramma kathasa kalam vipalam bhajo godrum kanana ranjividum bhajo godrum kanana ranjividum bhajo godrum kanana ranjividum vanchakalpa darusya kipasindh bhavacha Patitanang Pavane Bhavishnabhyo Namo.